Hi, I'm Melissa Curl, and I'm the Liaison Librarian for History, International Studies, and Political Science. In this video, I'm going to show you some tips that will improve your keyword searching in the Taylor & Francis Politics, International Relations, and Security Collections database. To do that, I'm going to show you some advanced search options, including using and, or, and not operators. To do this, when you type and in between two terms, in this example, cat and dog, the database knows that you are looking for results that include both terms, cat and dog. This happens automatically in most databases, including this one. If you type cat, dog, the and is implied in between them. What's not automatic is using or to search for documents containing at least one of two or more search terms. For example, if you type cat or dog, you'll find documents that include the term cat, documents that include the term dog, and documents where both terms appear. This is very useful when you're searching for topics that can be represented using multiple terms. Not is used to eliminate a term, for example, cat, not dog. Also useful to know that if you use quotation marks around an exact phrase that is two or more words long, you can search for those two terms together in that order. And I'm going to show you with an example what that looks like in practice. For example, if I type climate refugees into the search bar, I'm looking for documents that include both the word climate and the word refugees, but they could be anywhere in the document. They don't have to be together. And that's for that reason I have more than 19,000 results when I search for just those two words. However, when I enclose them together in quotation marks as a phrase, my results are dramatically reduced to 345 because I'm searching then for terms, for sources that contain the exact term climate refugees. However, there's other phrases that can be used to represent the same concept. For example, looking at just the first result, I also see the phrase climate migrants, which would be another way of representing the same topic as climate refugees. If you think back to algebra, you may remember that when you enclose something in parentheses, it means that you have to do that thing first. So I can tell the database that I would be okay with either a document that has the phrase climate refugees or the phrase climate migrants, both enclosed here in quotation marks. This widens my search a little bit, and now I have 400 results, an additional 55. So I may have climate migrants that don't include the phrase climate refugees, but it still would be relevant to my research. I can use and to add in another concept, for instance, the concept of asylum. Now I only have 55 results, so each of these results will include either the phrase climate refugees or the phrase climate migrants, or both, as in this example, and the word asylum. Another way to look for other representations of how you can phrase your term would be to do a quick Google search. For instance, when I search Google for climate refugees, I find that the Wikipedia page is called environmental migrant, which is another way that I could represent that term. It's a good idea as you're going along to keep a bank of potential keywords. For instance, oops, just delete that. I see here that all these five terms are the same, are representing the same concept of climate refugees. Here's another concept, asylum, another concept, international law. All ways to represent the same thing. Keyword searching can be iterative, so try different combinations and see which one works for you. Keeping track like this is a way to make sure that you figure out what works well and what could potentially be improved. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this useful, and please remember you can always reach out with any questions.